Senior Life Journeys presents Carol Howell's Let's Talk Dementia, a podcast designed to help caregivers find knowledge, power, hope, and smiles in their dementia caregiving journey. Welcome to Let's Talk Dementia. Here is your host, best-selling author, Carol Howell.
Hi, hardworking caregivers. This is Carol Howell with another edition of Let's Talk Dementia. Looking at my hair here in this picture, and it looks okay right now, but as you know, we are under quarantine, which means I can't go get my hair cut. Now, there's a few things in my life that will drive me bonkers crazy, and one of them is when my hair gets long and thick. I have very thick hair, and it starts getting heavy, and it won't do right. So one day, I just may sign up here on this show, and you look at me, and I've taken and buzz cut it all off. It could happen. I'm just going to tell you. Well, I hope you're having a good day and that you have found some joy and some sunshine and some smiles in your dementia caregiving journey. I realize that there are some of you folks who watch this show or listen to it that are not caregivers, but you have dementia, and I don't think I've ever really addressed you, and I apologize for that, because I know there's a lot of folks who are in the early stages of their disease, are learning and investigating and growing in their knowledge, and I hope that this show is a help to you. I'm happy to hear from anyone, and you can email me, and that email address is carol@letstalkdementia.org. You can go to that same website, letstalkdementia.org, and click on calendar events and schedule a 30-minute free consultation with me for whatever's going on in your world and in your world of dementia. And I'm happy to talk with you, no charge whatsoever. So be glad for you to do that. Well, I wanted to talk with you about a subject we've covered many times, but maybe a little further on this subject of maybe changing the mind of your loved one. We won't call it bearing false witness. That's a good biblical term for telling a lie. But maybe changing the mind of someone who has something going on in their brain that they absolutely are sure of, and you know what they're thinking is not accurate, and you want to make it right, and you can't. And that's not your job. Your job is not to change the mind or to convince the individual of with dementia of anything. That's not your job. You see, they know what they know. And I've told you before that if they say to you, I want to go see my daddy, and you say to them, well, your daddy died in 1962 and you're not going to get to go see him, how that's a cruel thing to do. I've done that on many shows. I've covered that with you. But you know, sometimes it's the little things that we don't think about that we try to change the mind or correct to bring proper information to our loved one. Little things that maybe we shouldn't do, such as if they say to you, this is not my house. I want to go home. This is not where I live. I don't live here. These are not my things. And you know that it is. And you can go, look, isn't this your bed? Well, yeah, that's my bed, but this isn't my house. I know this isn't my house. And you can continue to try to convince them that this room in this bed in this room in this house is theirs. And it probably is. But in their mind, they are living so far back in time that it doesn't add up, because they may be living in 1962, and that is not the house they lived in at that time. And even if it is the house they lived in, it looks different. I sure hope it does. And they know that what they're seeing is not adding up with what their brain knows. And you trying to convince them otherwise, it's not nice. Don't do that. Don't keep showing them things and trying to convince them of this action or this fact or that fact. It's just going to agitate them. Now, if it doesn't agitate them, they may be the kind of person that goes, well, I think you're probably right. Okay. And as soon as you leave, they are in total confusion, total frustration, sadness, anxiety. You've just heaped it on by trying to get them to see your point of view. And I just want to ask you something. Has that ever really worked for you? When you are working with your children or your spouse or your sisters or brothers or your employer or whatever, and you're trying to convince them of your point of view, that just doesn't easily happen. We're all hard-headed people. We know what we know, and please don't mess with what we know. And the folks with dementia, they're like that too. and they know what the house they lived in looked like. And you're telling them, I live here? What? This is not my house. You're crazy. So they either going to become agitated with you or agitated with themselves or both. And I'm just going to tell you something. You don't want any of those situations. And it's situations that can be avoided. You can make sure that doesn't happen. So what you will say to them is, you know what? This is not your house, but how about we just sit down here for a minute, take a rest, and I wanted to tell you a story of something that happened to me last night. Well, okay, come on. So we get them in there and we get them seated in what truly is their house or their bedroom or their apartment in their assisted living or memory care. And we sit there and talk to them a little bit. Have a story ready to tell them because you said you were going to tell them one of something that happened at your house last night. And if you got to make up a great big old golly whopper of a story, I don't care. Just tell them something to help them right at that moment. They're probably going to forget that conversation you just had about it not being their house. And if they don't forget it, if they do remember it, which they might, it may stay on their brain for a little bit, then you want to keep talking with them, recommend we go do something, and always say, well, let's go to the kitchen to get a snack, because I'm telling you, food is the universal language. Everybody says it's music, but it's food. It will change the mind and the mood of most anybody. My husband has discerned in our world that a vanilla wafer is the cure to everything. I'm not sure, but what he might be right. So use those techniques. Don't belittle your person by trying to convince them of what you know to be true when they know good and well it's not. Okay, just don't do that. It's not a good plan. Go with their story. All right, I will see you on the next episode of Let's Talk Dementia.
Let's Talk Dementia would like to thank our sponsors, National Association of Veterans and Families. You can reach them at 800-352-2919 on the internet at www.navf.org. They speak veterans, so you don't have to. And you tell them Carol sent you when you call to inquire about benefits for the veteran, the spouse of the veteran, or both. Editor Beth. You can find Ms. Beth Crosby at editorbeth.com. She is amazing at looking at what you've written and making sure it represents you well. Find her at www.editorbeth.com. And HD Imports, located on Flint Street Extension in Rock Hill, South Carolina. That's York County. 803-985-0985. They are there for the repair and maintenance of your Honda, Hyundai, Toyota, Kia. Tell them Carol sent you.
Thanks for joining us today for Carol Howell's Let's Talk Dementia. To learn more about dementia, we recommend Carol's best-selling book, also titled Let's Talk Dementia. It's available on Amazon in paperback and Kindle versions. Be sure to like Let's Talk Dementia on Facebook and leave us a kind word of review on iTunes. Remember, knowledge brings power. Power brings hope. Hope brings smiles. And we all need more smiles. Thanks for joining us today, and we'll be right here when you come back to Let's Talk Dementia.